So good morning students. So in this video we are going to discuss about our next two questions, like question number 8 and question number 9. So here in question number 8 it is given, like, if there are 20 students and the ratio of boys to girls is 3:2, then find the number of boys and girls. So suppose there are 20 students in a class and the ratio of boys to girls is 3:2, mean the ratio of boys is 3 and the ratio of girls is 2. Then we have to find out the number of boys and number of girls separately. So here, because these are ratio are given, so we can write it like share of boys is equal to 3x and share of girls is equal to 2x. Now if we are adding both of the share, because these are the share of boys and girls, if we are adding both of the share, so it is equals to total number of students. So share of boys is equal to 3x plus share of girls is equal to 2x equals to 20. So if we are adding these two numbers, we are getting 5x is equal to 20. And here we can write it like x is equals to 20 upon 5. So 5 banja 5 and 5 4 ja 20. So here we are getting x equals to 4. So this is the value of x. So here we have to find out the number of boys equals to 3x. So this is the share, and number of girls equals to 2x. So this is the share, and we have to find out number of boys and number of girls. So 3x equals to 3:4. Why we are writing 3:4? Because here the value of x, we have already find out that the value of x is 4. That's why we can write it like 3:4. 3 is this, and the value of x is equal to 4. That's why we are writing 4 here. 2 is this, and the value of x is equal to 4. That's why we are writing 4 here. So here we are getting the answer 12, in the number of boys in the school are 12 and number of girls are 8 in that class. So 20 students were there, in the ratio of 3:2, the ratio of boys is equal to 3x, the ratio of girls is equal to 2x. 3x plus 2x is equal to 20, 5x is equal to 20, and x is equal to, we can write it in fraction, 20 upon 5, x is equal to 4 we are getting. So number of boys, here we have to put the value of x, and we are getting that the number of boys are 12 and number of girls are 8. So in our next question, you can see if there are 26 players and the ratio of swimmers to cyclist is 6:7, then find the number of swimmers and cyclists. So here you can see in all the questions the method is same, everything is given in ratio, and we have to find out the number because total number of players or students are already given. So 26 players are given, so total number of players are 26, and the ratio of swimmers and cyclists are in the ratio of 6:7. So here we will start by writing shares of swimmers equals to 6x, shares of cyclists equals to 7x. 6x equals to and 7x it is given here. So total number of players are 26, so we can also write it like 6x plus 7x equals to 26. So after adding these two numbers, we are getting 13x equals to 26 and x equals to 26 upon 13. So here we can cut both of the numbers, 13 and 13 to the 26. So here we can write it like x equals to 2. So this is the value of x we are getting. So here we have to write the find out the number of swimmers. So number of swimmers equals to 6x equals to 6:2, because this is the value of x, and number of cyclists, this is the share, 7x, and here we are writing 7:2 because this is the value of x. So what we are getting in the answer, 6:12. So here we can see the number of swimmers are 12 and number of cyclists are 14. So because the ratio are given, ratio is given here 6:7, so that's why we are getting the answer 12 and 14. So this is how you will find out all the answer method are same. So you had to try to solve. You had to try to solve question number 10, 11, and 12 because all the question are same here.